Sorry about that, since it's because the browser is not a support the sharing scheme. Now I change to another one.
Okay, no worries.
Okay, let's start. Okay, so now you can see my skin, right?
Yes, we can.
Okay, sorry. Thank you for your help and good afternoon, every student. Okay, sorry that you have to meet me. Let me introduce myself again. So I am Dr. Shou Tong Shu Tong. Yeah, let's meet. Okay, Charlotte Chu Tong. Okay, so today is my honor that it's my pleasure that will be your online lecturer. And today I may tell you about my research that use the deep learning technique on the to solve the problem in the real life. If you have the question or you have in you have question and you can ask me. Okay, and currently I am a head of the computer science program department of the computer science and information and at Kasetsart University Thailand, and I graduated from the National Central University Taiwan. Yeah, same head with the Dr. Leo. And I would like to thank you, Dr. Leo and Professor Didit, yeah, that invites me to be the speaker for your class. And for my research, I interest about the deep learning and AI tech mining recommendation system and social media mining. Okay, and here is the website of the my faculty of my university. However, my university has the four campuses. The first one is the Bang Khien campus in the Bangkok. This one is the main campus, and I am here, Siracha campus, in the second one campus, and another one is Kampen San campus, and the fourth one is the Sukhonakorn campus. Yeah, this one is the Thailand map. You can see, so we have total is we have four campuses. Okay, this one is just a background about me. So today I will share you about three main topics. The first one is the applying deep learning for the learning content summarization. So this one is a problem about education. Yeah. And another, the second one is the applying deep learning technique for the wavelength industries. And the last one, applying the deep learning for the lowing player machine. This one is for sport. Okay, so we can see that like we can use the knowledge from the deep learning and we can program it and we can build the model and solve the problem with the really with the many problem in the our life. Okay, so let's start with the first topic. Okay, I think you may heard or hear some words about the text summarization in the computer side, right? We have the data, like we have many kind of the data types. The first one is the text, right? And number, right? Okay, and image. And video, right? Okay, this one, we have like a many kind of the data. And this one is one of the technique that we summarize the content in the text. In the text summarization, is it the technique that we want to shorten the last piece of the content with the main point or the main idea. We want to summarize it, want to shorter than the text, want to use our words and use the main idea. Why it become the critical? Because in the real life, we got a lot of data from the internet, right? But we have the limited time. How we can get the most important contents from a lot of the data? The machine learning or the NLP? Do you know NLP? Natural language processing. I'm sorry about this. Natural language processing, NLP. Yeah, it can help us to do the task summarization. It can help us to get the main important from the whole data. Okay, we found a problem in the life, right? The value of the data continue actually going. We got a lot of data from the internet, such as the reviews, blogs, right? Status of the social media, a lot of the textbook, a lot of the content in the newspaper, even though in the journals. And how we can know the important content in this, right? And we don't have the time. We have the limited time. Everyone wants to get useful information in this time. Yes. And it has two ways for do the text summarization. The first one we call the extension-based summarization. Yeah. In the extension-based, you think like a highlighter. I think all students here know the highlighter, okay? The highlighter is look like you want to highlight the main important word in the sentence or in the document. And then you get that word to be a summary. For the example, if you have the short text, Peter and Elizabeth took a taxi to attend the night party in the city, right? Why in the party? Elizabeth chorus and was rushed to the hospital. And then you can see like which word is important. Okay, Peter and Elizabeth attend party city. Elizabeth rushed to the hospital. So we use this set of word to be a summary. This one we call the extension. The extension is create the summary without making any change. Okay, so that why we compare it like a highlighter. And another technique we call the abstraction. Okay, the abstraction is like we take a look at the short text and we realize the content is our own word and make it like a summary. You can see the results from the abstraction and extension is different, right? Okay, this one is the normal technique for the text summarization. And many people, they also study about text summarization. But when I study, it's already have done, right? And how I want to do the research about this one, we have to find the problem. In the real life, we can use the text summarization for any applications, such as news headline generation, outline of student, movie previews, text classification, question and answering. Uh-huh. And as I tell you before, right, it's many company and many researchers, they also study about the text summarization. They also build the program, build the agent to help us for summarize the content such as the cue board you can see here, hugging face, and yeah, clearly is a ChatGPT. The ChatGPT can you put your contents, you put your text, and let ChatGPT to summarize. It can summarize the contents for you. But I found that in the YouTube, I think all students here know the YouTube, right? But the YouTube, sometimes we study on the YouTube, but sometimes the YouTube is a long video. Okay, I can show you some example here. Now I click. Wait a minute. Okay. Do you see my screen in the YouTube?
Yes.
Okay. Ah, sorry. Okay, this one I just show you some example. Like sometimes we also study by ourselves, right? By the video or by the online content. If you take a look at this video, it take a time around 1 hour. But are there someone can sit down on the computer and take a look the video 1 hour? Anyone? Are there anyone that can take a look at the video for 1 hour? Or you just click and skip, yeah, for get the important content. So how we can summarize this educational video? Yeah, we found a problem like this video is so boring. It's just some speaker and talk about the learning content. And no action, no movie is so boring, right? And is it possible that can we summarize the contents based on the educational video? Yeah, this one is the problem. So we can use the deep learning technique help us to summarize the contents from educational video. And then it can help us to generate the summary like this. But now this one is generated by the human, right? And in the future, how we can generate some kind of this description by the algorithm, by the deep learning or the machine learning algorithm. Okay, this is the idea, right? So in my research, I also study about this one, and I use the CNN for text. CNN is the convolutional neural network, and this one is can be like a help us to represent the word. Okay, and this CNN is one kind of deep learning technique, right? And based on a neural network, it can use for the learn the feature of the word. Okay, it can help us to learn about how the importance of the content in the sentence. Okay, if you want to know more about the CNN structure, you can search in the Google or search in the internet. In my class today, I just want to show you like how we can apply the deep learning to solve the problem. Okay, and I do the research and publish one paper. It's called an attention enhanced sentence feature network to subtitle attention and summarization. Okay, if you see the title of the research is like a, okay, Okay, we use the subtitle of the video, right? And we summarize the subtitle, okay, to be the video description. Okay, firstly, we have to get the subtitle for video first, and then to do the pre-training process. The subtitle is a text, right? Text cannot be directly to the DL model, right? We have to convert text to be like a some kind of the number that we call it the feature vector, right? Okay, so we use the some kind of the neural network help us to build the feature vector, and then we can do the next step and build the summarization. Okay. I may show you about the step by step for text summarization for the video, right? Firstly, you have to create some function and get the data from the YouTube. This kind of data is like a text. It's a subtitle from the YouTube. And then you have to clean data. Some kind of the data that you don't want to use in like a time. It's like a number. You have to clean it. You have to remove it. And then you get any text. And then in here it shows the number of data set. I use this type of the channel from the YouTube, TED.com, TED Talk channel, 2 minute paper channel. This one is the YouTube channel. And this one is the number of the sentence from the subtitle. You can see here. We have to divide data into the training set and testing set. Okay, and then when you already remove the noise, remove the number that you don't want, you will get the subtitle, right? And you have to convert each sentence to be the vector. Okay, you do the text processing, sentence organization, stop word removing. You have to convert the sentence to be some kind of the number. Okay, that's it. And then this one is the one of this one. This picture shows the step of the pre-processing before you use the deep learning to learn how important of the sentence. How do you know the which sentence is important? You have to give it the score. This score we call the sentence saliency score. We can calculate score by use some kind of the formula. We call the Lusch technique. The Lusch technique is stand for recall oriented understudy of the gradient evaluation. Yeah, you can call it Lusch. It assess of the method. Okay, that can calculate the how similar of the sentence between the ground truth and between the thought. Okay, I may show you the example because it quite take a time if we want to know detail. So I may show you the example. Okay. After you get the subtitle from the video, right, you will get the text like this. And then you have to separate all document to be a sentence, to be a sentence, sentence, sentence. And then if you get the sentence like this, right, this one is the one sentence, you have to calculate how important of this sentence. For the example, this sentence is Bart Thomas, who has this sentence has score is 0.1. So it means 0.1 sometimes is not important sentence for this video, right? And then we have to convert this sentence to be a metric, to be a number like this. In order to convert the sentence to the number like this, you can use GOV. GOV is a global vector of word representation. Okay? As I tell you, like a text cannot directly feed to the deep learning model, you have to convert text to be the number first. This one, the GOV, is a one kind of the method that help us to convert text to be a number. Okay, right? And then you have to calculate the score, sentence score. Okay, after that, you can use the deep learning model. It's like a LSTM or the CNN and help us to get the important score. This one is the structure of the structure of the how to calculate the sentence score. If you want to know in your detail, you can go to my paper and take a look, but today we don't have time too much. Okay, and I may show you the result like this. This one is the result from the model that can help us to summarize the content from the subtitle, from the video subtitle. Okay. When we do the deep learning model, right, we have to prepare the ground truth. The ground truth is mean the answer, the real answer that prepared by the human. And then we have to compare the output from the model. This one is the output from the model. This one is from the deep learning model, right? And this one is the output, the real output from the human. You can see that the model can predict or can summarize. It's same with the human. The green one is the model. The green one is the same sentence, right? And for the, like a direct match, mm-hmm. And the gray one is the indirect match, but it's the same meaning. Okay, this one is another example. And the left-hand side is the results from the model, and the right-hand side, the result from the human. Okay. You can see that the model can generate the summary, same with the human. Okay. And now we have the transformer. Transformer is another deep learning technique that also apply for many kind of work, also apply for the text. We call the bidirectional encoder representation, or can call it BERT. BERT is a one way of the help us to summary. Okay, the BERT is a one way that can help us to represent the text in the feature vector also. This one is the BERT structure. I may not go to it in the detail, but if you want to know more about BERT, you can go to this paper. I just want to tell you like that. If we have the text, right? For the example, I love you. If you have a text like this, and then you put this sentence to the BERT model, and then you will get some number, like a feature vector. For example, like this. Okay, so this this vector it represents I love you. Okay, and then you can use this one to do the your work for as you want. You can feed this feature to the deep learning model and do another kind of work like a text classification, text summarization, and text generation. Yeah, the bird is just a one way that can help us to for the sentence representation. Okay. The bird they use the attention. Attention is like a it's like a in the sentence, right? For example, sentence like I love you, but I don't like your dog, for example. Okay, the attention is mean which word we should attend we should give more weight for attention. For example, I, okay, we can give more attention at the I word. Love, we can give more attention at the love word. But this word, we don't want attention. Yeah, the attention mechanism can help us which word in the sentence is important. Okay, yeah, this one is the structure of the attention. Okay, and for this work, we also apply the bird for summarization also, but we use the for the technical video talk. In here is the structure of the model. It's so complicated. Okay. Okay. So we can go to another problem. This one, we apply the deep learning model for solve the problem in the weaving industries. I think our student here also do some kind of the project and want to apply the deep learning technique for solve some problem. This one is the example, okay? And okay. In the weaving industry, they have the machine, right? The machine continue at work, yeah, continue at the weaving. And how we can know like the fabric have some defect. If we can know like the fabric is have the defect, right? We can stop the machine early. Uh-huh. And then, so how we can know? We can do like automatic mask detection on fabric production video by AI. Okay, in this work, we have like the problem. Okay, in the fabric, we call like this one is a one kind of the defects, and this one is another kind of the defects. How we can detect this kind of the defect on the fabric? Okay, we use the VGG 15 model. The VGG is the one kind of the convolutional neural network. It's also deep learning technique. The VGG can help us to learn the feature of the image. This one is the structure of the VGG. Uh-huh. And it has the scene in totally 16 layers. Is a 60 layer of the scene end, okay? And then we apply the autoencoder. The autoencoder is mean like if you have a picture here, right? You have a picture here. And then you focus only this area, right? And then we just zoom in this area, and then get the feature important of this picture in this area. Okay, so this is the structure of the autoencoder. Okay. And how do you know, like, this picture and this picture is different? For example, this one is the picture of the normal fabric, and this one is the picture of the fabric have the defect. How do you know this picture is different or similar? We can use some kind of technique like a structural similarity index measure to calculate how difference of the picture. Okay, and this one X, and this one is picture X, and this one is the picture Y. And then you use this formula and compute it. And then you can know like a picture X and picture Y is difference or not. Okay. Okay, let me show this one. In this research topic, you have the picture of the video, right? And then, you have the video of the fabric, right? And then you do the segmentation, like a form video. You segment it to the picture, to the image. And then you do the pre-process. After that, you feed all image to the VGT16 with encoder. In the VGT 16, it will help us to learn the feature of the image. And then go to the SSIM function to compare how difference of the image. And then we can predict like this image defect or not defect. Okay. If the image have some damage, we will mark it in the video, in the image. So if the model can detect like, okay, the damage is happened, it can stop the machine. Okay. This one is show you the step of the detection. Okay. For the detection process, it will do like the sliding window. If you have the R image right there, right? If you have the R image right there, it will do like a sliding window. First one, you will focus only this area, and next one, you start by one and go to this area, and next one you start by one, go to this area and go to this area until whole image, and then model you can learn the feature of this small picture, and then they can find the defect on the image. Okay. Here is a show the example of the mark lesions on the image size 256 pixels. Is this one is the mark lesion with the 128 pixel images. Okay. In the experiments, we have to experiments based on the many kind of the threshold, right? This one we compare with the difference value of the SSIM. The figure A is show the we use the 0.4 of the SSIM, And figure B, we use the 0.5 of the SSIM. And figure C, we use the 0.6 of the SSIM. And figure D, we use the 0.7 of the SSIM. Because we don't know like which value of the SSIM is suitable for our image, for our data set. So we have to try it. And after that, we can conclude like, yes, the SSIM is that suitable for us is the 0.7 and 0.8. Okay, this one is the results of the defect detection. Okay, I may show you the video results. The original video. In the industry, you can use the camera, and the camera can capture the whole of the picture that the process of the fabric in the machine. It will capture whole video like this. Okay, this one is the original video. Okay, you can see. When they can detect the damage, right? It can go to the model and do the reconstruct the data and do the mask video. The model will detect the damage on the fabric. Take a time. Okay, this is our output. Yeah, this is the input video. Okay, I may okay. Yes, yeah. Okay. Maybe to okay, maybe allow this. For the example, right? This is the input video, and then we feed to okay. From the video, we separate it to the image. Image one, image two, image three, until image n, right? We split like a frame by frame, so we can get a lot of many images, and then we use our model, right? The model is based on the VGG16 and auto encoder. Autoencoder. This one is the deep learning model, and then inside this one is will put the back color on the another area, and put the mark color is this here is the white color, right? The white color on the damaged area. And then we can see easily see like how difference of the normal fabric and the damaged fabric. And after that, if the machine can detect like, oh, the damage happened, so it can stop the process. And here is the result from our model. Okay, This one is show the final video that the output of the deep learning model. Let me just keep it. Okay. So for in the real application, you can embed this model to be into the machine in the industry, and then you can the human cannot like stand and check the quality of the fabric all time, right? We can use some kind of this technique, and then it can help us to detect. Okay. And another topic is apply the deep learning technique or the machine learning model for clustering growing pair. And this one is will be public in the ICNCC conference. Do you know the growing spot? The rowing is a one kind of the sport that the pair sit together in the boat, right? And for the rowing, they have like a single pair, double pair, and couple pair. And in the practice, the pair have to practice, and then when they and then coach will match them together. Coach will match the pair together in the same boat, but sometimes have a problem like a human bias and how we can know the performance of the pair. In the pair that sit in the same boat, they should have the same action. They should have the same performance. When they have the same performance and same action or same frequency in the rowing, yeah, the boat it can go really fast, right? And then how we can apply the deep learning help us to matching the pair together. So in this lesson, we use the video of the pair practice. Normally when the pair they practice, they will practice based on this machine like this. This one is the machine for the pair practice. Okay, they will practice like this. It's a lot of video, I may show you. Okay, so in this research, we use this kind of the video as our data set. The data set is the composed of 15 size short video for the player playing in the rowing machine. Okay, and each video is recorded by the resolution. Here is show the resolution is around 1920 and 1080, right? And around 60 frames per second. And then we use this one to classify which pair should be together, which pair should same board. And then we use these 4 points. 1, 2, 3, and 4 about shoulder, elbow, hip, and knee. We attack this point of the pair. Okay, as the feature of the player, like light shoulder, light elbow, light hip, light knee. Okay, and joint is like joint one, joint two, joint three, as show this table. Okay, how we can attack the joints of the player? We use the media pipe. Do you know the media pipe? The media pipe is one kind of the deep learning technique that can help us to attack the joints of the body. They can attack around 22 joints of the bodies. Here is show the index of the joint that they can attack from the videos from the bodies. Zero is nose, right? One is left eye inner, and two is left eye, and three is left eye outer, yeah, and so on. We use the media pose to attack these four joints in the video, okay? And we use the angle and strength and the aptitude. The angle of the shoulder, angle of the elbow, angle of hip, and angle of knees. And the strength of the shoulder, strength of the elbow, strength of hip, and strength of knee. And aptitude of the shoulder, elbow, hips, and knee. Okay. So it means we will have like a 12, right? 12 square loop for each pair. Each pair. So we have 12 value for each pair, and we use these 12 value to match pair together. Okay, this one is showed some example of the angle data. Okay, in the media buy, when you use the media buys and take the data from video, you can get the value of the shoulder, value of the elbow, value of the hip, value of the knees. This one is the example value. And this one is the example value when lower, like the pair like this. And this one is the example like a pair like this posture. Okay. Okay, this one we call like a one cycle. When they do this and back to this, yeah, this one is called one cycle. If the people, they can show the performance in one cycle, it's the same angle for the shoulder, elbow, and hip. It means that they can like they can move together. Well, okay. Here is the first chart of the proposed model. We input the rowing video of the 15 pairs, right? And then we do the segmentation of video, like a frame by frame, and apply the media bias, and then calculate the angle, and then we also calculate the angle speed by using the Fourier transform and prepare the feature of the pairs like aptitude, angle speed of the four joints, and apply the clustering method and analyze the results. Okay. When we already prepare the feature of the pair, we also apply the machine learning method. It's a clustering method. The first one is the Bish clustering. The Bish clustering can help us to group the pair together. You can see this one is the cluster zero, cluster one, I cluster zero, and green one represent the cluster one, and yellow one represent the cluster two, right? and it means like the player 10, player 12, player 9 can be the same group. It can be the same board. They can go to the same board, and player 1, player 2, and player 3 also can go to the same board. Player 7, player number 4 can go to the same board. And this one is the result from beach coupling. Okay. We also experiment with different K value. K is mean the number of group. This one is the 11 group. This one is 12 group. And this one is the 13 group. Yeah. And we also compare with the claim. Oh, sorry. And we also apply the claim mean clustering and see the results with K, with difference value of K, 15, 7, K, and also use the Gaussian mixture clustering with different K. This one is the results, okay. Okay. So finally, we found that the good number of the group is 13. And we can matching like the player number 3 and number 2 can go to the same board. You can see number 3, number 2. Difference clustering method is also show the same results. And for the number player number 9, 12, and number 9, 12, and can match together and can go to the same board. Okay. Okay. This is the example that we can use the deep learning method for a deep learning technique to solve some kind of the problem in the our life. The first one is for the summarize the content. Okay, I can go back to the content summarization. And then if you have a problem about this one, you can ask me for the content summarization. Okay. So, students have any question about the content summarization?
Okay, if you have any question, please feel free to raise your hand or write in the chat box. Anyone have a question? There is one in the chat box. How does extraction-based summarization differ from other summarization techniques, and what are its key advantages and limitations?
Okay. For the effective summarization, we still use the same words from the original. So, okay, so it means it can, for the syntax errors, when we compare with another technique, the syntax error of the extraction summarization is very less, is less than another technique. Sometimes if you use the abstract summarization, you still find some error on the sentence because they cannot know like this is the verb, this is a noun, and they clearly still generate the long word. But for the extraction summarization, they use the original words from the short text, right? So the error rate is less than another technique. the people still can read and understand. Yes, for the another technique is sometimes they found lots of error in the summarization results.
Thank you. Is there any other questions? So, this talk was about the implementation of deep learning in real life problem that may be very useful for you guys when you have your final project later. I think it will start in the end of next week. You will face this kind of implementation for your final project.
Okay. And how about this one? How about the topic? This topic, do you have any question about our fabric detection?
Hey, students, do you have any questions about this fabric detection? Defect detections?
This one, the input be the video, the input is the video, right? Okay, the first topic, the input is the text. I hope you can yeah, you can get some idea for your work. And this one is now you can, I'm not sure, it's a many version of the VGG that you can apply. You can use the many kind of the neural network and compare the results. And you can change this one, the input is the video of the fabric, right? You can change to another kind of video. It's like a like a product video of the some kind of the product. Yeah, it can use for help for the detect some damage on the product. Okay. Here is the library of my student that they use for traffic detection. First one, they use the OpenCV. The OpenCV is a library for help us to get the data for 2D and 3D image. And they use the group two. Group two is help us to rename the files of the video. When we input the video, right, and then you have separate like a frame by frame of the image, you will got a lot of the image. You have to rename the image like a sequence of the image. It can help you to organize your data. And here this library is a diff image. Okay, they use for using the they use for find the difference image. And this one virtual class is help us for use the deep learning model for the visualized data and scikit-learn and NumPy. I think you already know about this and TensorFlow. TensorFlow also is a library that help us to create a machine learning model. Okay, you can apply this kind of the library for your project. Okay, this is the system structure. So, any question about this topic?
Okay. Okay, maybe one from me. So before I go to the chat box, I want to ask, maybe it is also a question for a lot of students here. What is a basic theory that students must excel or maybe understand when they want to implement deep learning like this? Or does library help a lot such that we don't really need to really understand about the basic theory of it?
Okay, so firstly, it's of course, it's a programming skill, yeah. And for the deep learning and machine learning, it's mainly library that is developed in the Python language. So students should have like the Python skill, and you can find many kind of the that I mean the source code that help the student to prepare the data set, like to prepare the image, to prepare the feature vector. It's many of the data. If student want to use video data or image data, student should know about the characteristic of the image. It's like they have like a green, blue, red channels of the picture, right? One pixel of the picture, they have like a green, blue, and red. Yeah, they should know about the characteristic of the data first. And then of course the Python, and you have to learn about the machine learning technique, basically like classification techniques, clustering techniques, yes, of the machine learning. And important like math skill. Yeah. Okay, and I saw the question from the chat. Okay, they use the Python mostly. Okay. Because as I told before, like many library that's support us for do the machine learning, like a scikit-learn, they also implement in the Python. So it's easy for you that you learn the Python and then you can call the library from the maybe from the GitHub or from the TensorFlow or from the Anaconda. Yeah, it can help you for do the your program. What do you see as the most interesting change in the development of the learning as a person?
Okay, maybe I will give you some context. So before, in a few weeks ago, we talked about the development in deep learning. So for example, we have deep fake, where there are fake videos like that. And what is the most recent development we have in deep learning? I think that is Agung. That what was Agung means.
I see. Okay. And how about the last topic? Any student have the question for the okay. Applying the machine learning model for clustering the loading pair. You also can Google, and a lot of you will get like how to use the MediaVine. It's a free library. You can test and experiment by yourself, and in the MediaVine, it can like help you for detect anything. You can go. Maybe I can Yeah, they also have the example of using the media pies, maybe like a posture detection. You can apply for the exercise. You can apply for the hand language. Yeah, in the hand language, the media pies can detect the choice of your hand, the poise of your hand. You can like do the gesture control.
There is another question. What if you are bad at math? Can you still manage to get through learning about deep learning and machine learning? Because that's also one of my problem learning this topic. Thank you.
Math at yeah, it's no need to good, but if you bad at math, yeah, you can still learning about the deep learning, but how to say okay since okay you can develop like the base. The normal how to say it. Okay, you can build some kind of a model, but if you want to improve the model, you may need to know how to improve it, because the back end of the deep learning, they have the math, right? Okay, so if you want to improve the performance of your model, you have to know how to calculate the value and how to adjust the formula. But if you bet, you can ask the ChatGPT actually. You can ask like, hi ChatGPT, how you help us to solve this formula? Help us to, yeah, I think if you good at the logic, if you good at the logic, you know like the step of the your implement, I think you can work on the deep learning. And if you good at like searching, you know, if you can good at like use the search engine, I think you can do it.
Okay, we have a next question from Romario. Miss, that means deep learning based architecture that used in advancing AI image detection, it's kind similar to the video processing process, like MediaPipe post or something like that.
Yes, yes.
And what is the main difference between the two?
Advanced AI's image detection is kind of similar. Actually, it's the same, but they. S1 AI image detection is kind of similar to video processing. It's like a media file processing. Actually, the same idea, but they may use the big of the data set. Then the machine can learn more, can learn very well. Are there a real sign we can take?
We also have another question from Marcel. What do you think is most interesting in the current development of deep learning, and are there any new or significant innovation that we can take in our learning in the current development of deep learning?
Okay. If we talk about the deep learning, we may think about we should have a lot of the data that can let the machine learn about the pattern of the data, right? But in the life, we also cannot find the big data like that. If we can do like a generative AI, it's mean that just the machine can learn only a few data. Now, can learn on a few data, and then they can learn about the pattern of the data based on a few data. This topic is maybe most I say really interested about this one is a generative AI.
Is there any other question? I think.
Generative AI.
I think there's no more question, and maybe if there's no other question, we can all hear. My name is Fernando Agusti. What are the recent development in the field of deep learning that could have a significant impact?
Maybe about the art, about art, about the music, about like a creative work. Because in the past we think like the AI cannot repeat us, right, about the creative work. Because we think like human is also creative, but clearly is they can generate the art, right? It can generate the image art, it can generate the song, like a creative work. Yeah, I think this one is some kind of the impact that we have to we should learn about this, I think.
Any other question? Yeah, friends, you can also do the second attendance check. It's open for 15 minutes. I think there's no other question, Dr. Chalaton. Maybe we can end our session now. Do you have any final words for the students?
Okay, and also thank you for inviting me to be your speaker for today, and I hope my work also can be your inspiration and you may get some idea to continue your project's work. And I don't talk in the detail because it's quite complicated. I just want to show you about some topic that I and my student have done before that use the deep learning for solve some problem in the real life. Okay, I hope like my content can inspire you and tell you like you can get some idea for your project. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much again, Ms. Chutong. So we can end our public lecture today. Thank you all for coming. Good day, and for students, see you again next week. Thank you again, Miss.
Okay, thank you. Bye bye.
Bye.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss. Thank you, Miss.
Thank you.
You.
Teman-teman, untuk presentasi bisa di LMS ya, yang kedua. The second attendance check can be accessed on LMS. Thank you all. See you again next week.